absolute value inequalities, greater than. This is a play on words. It's a way to help you remember what direction things go a little bit. So what it means if we have the absolute value is greater than 2, it means that the distance from 0 is more than 2. Remember, absolute value has to do with the distance. So if we have an absolute value that looks like this, this is a graph of a compound or inequality. It could be written as x is less than negative 2 or x is greater than 2. So if the absolute value is greater than a number, we are setting up an OR equation situation where we're getting this type of graph. Let's take a look at our examples. So in example 1, we have the absolute value of 2x minus 1 is greater than or equal to 7. Just like we were doing the absolute value equations before, we're going to set up two equations. One's going to be 2x minus 1 is greater than or equal to 7. We'll have it just exactly as it's written. The other one we're solving for the negative. And if you remember back when you were solving inequalities, we said that if we multiply by negative, we flip direction. So that's what we're going to do here. We're going to flip the direction on the second inequality where we're going to put in our negative. Now we solve. So I'm going to add 1 to both sides. I have 2x is greater than or equal to 8, divide by 2, and x is greater than or equal to 4. There's part of my solution. Now we do the other equation. We'll add 1 to both sides. We have 2x is less than or equal to negative 6, divide by 2, and x is going to be less than or equal to a negative 3. Now we'll do our graph. Down here is negative 3. Over here is 4. We have x is greater than or equal to 4. Whoops, I need to close my dot. Make sure that it shows up good. And we have a negative 3. And x is less than negative 3. So it goes that direction. Now for our solution, we are going from negative infinity to negative 3. We have the closed dot, so it means we have a bracket. Union, another closed dot, so we'll have another bracket. 4 to positive infinity. And that's our interval notation for that solution. Let's look at example 2. Again, we set up our one equation exactly like it is. We set up our second equation because we're going to multiply by a negative, we're going to flip the inequality, and so it'll be less than a negative 32. So now solve our two equations. Subtract 4 from both sides. We get 7x is greater than 28, divide by 7, and we get x is greater than 4. Subtract negative 4 from both sides. We get 7x is less than negative 36, divide by 7, and we get x is less than negative 36 sevenths. Okay, now we'll go to our graph. negative 36 sevenths is going to be down here somewhere. Our 4 will be up here. We're going to have open dots on this one because we don't have the equal. X is greater than 4, that means it's going to positive infinity. And then X is less than negative 36 sevenths, which means that one's going to negative infinity. Now, for our interval notation, we're going from negative infinity to negative 36 sevenths. We'll have parentheses for the open dot, union parentheses 4 to positive infinity.